Hi, Mike Redding here from usingtechnologybetter.com. How are you doing today? Today I'm going to show you a comparison of Teacher Dashboard by Hapara and Classroom by Google. We'll have a quick look at some of the positives and negatives, or some of the strengths and weaknesses of both programs, and then show you how you can use both together to get the best results. Now, for those of you who are looking at Google Classroom, you might have had a chance to sign up and have a bit of a play. You can set up your classrooms here. One of the greatest things about the way that Classroom is set up is that it's so easily organized here. So you can easily create assignments here, you can attach different types of documents, and all of your assignments sit here for the students to see. Now you can also, as a teacher, and your students can do this as well, you can post announcements and have a discussion going inside that same stream, which is a great feature. One of the great features that we have inside of Classroom is that the due date for a document or an assignment is very visible to both the teacher and the student. You can also get a quick overview of how many students have done the work and how many have turned that in. Now, from a teacher's point of view, the turn it in feature is fantastic. So when a student turns in an assessment task, it'll show up here that it's been turned in. And let me just show you what it looks like for a student. When they have their stream happening here, this is all the assessments that are due in this particular class. They can open an assessment here. And then once they're finished with it, they can either turn it in from this button here, or they can turn it in from right inside the document. So lots of teachers are loving it, students are loving it, and it's a very nice way to keep your work organized. In terms of sharing assignments, it's very easy to attach different document types. It's all just here. And you can attach multiple documents to an assessment task, which is a nice way of creating a topic maybe and giving the students all the work that they need. And then they can have all their work, once they turn it in, all in one neat place. The way it works inside your Drive account is really nice. You have a classroom folder just here. You'll have all your classes, and then all the different folders that you have are for each assessment that you've done. Plus, you can put your own teaching resources in that folder as well. So in terms of assigning tasks to students, in terms of keeping your work organized, it's a fantastic way to work. One of the downsides of using Classroom at the moment is that once you have shared a document with a student, you're still able to see that student working in that particular task, but you'd need to have one tab open for every student, unless the students are all working on a collaborative doc, of course. And so with this, the teacher overview can become a little bit complicated. And for teachers who are looking to be a little bit more proactive in their teaching, in terms of catching students who are falling behind before it's too late, this becomes a little bit cumbersome, and Teacher Dashboard does this feature really well. One of the other weaknesses of Google Classroom at the moment is that when you assign a document to the class, it gets assigned to the whole class. So unless you're creating different classes with different students in there, it's a little bit harder to assign documents to groups or to individual students. And once again, that's a real strength of Teacher Dashboard as well. One of the strengths of Classroom over Teacher Dashboard is the sharing functionality. Sharing inside Google Classroom is instantaneous, and you don't have to wait for the sharing function to run in the background via a script like they do in Teacher Dashboard. So when you assign a document to a particular student, it will end up in their Drive account instantaneously. So all you need to do is select that document, click Add, and give it a name, and then just click Assign, and that will be done straight away. Now you can set the sharing permissions just here, and you can make individual copies for a student, which is a great feature as well. Now, one last weakness of Google Classroom is that it's not very functional for schools that have different domains for their teachers and their students. Google Classroom can't work across multiple domains. Trusted domains aren't happening yet, and so this is a feature that's limited to a number of schools because they just can't access the program. Teacher Dashboard enables that to happen in a different kind of a way. So there's a couple of great strengths to Classroom, but there's a couple of weaknesses as well. When it comes to Teacher Dashboard, one of the great strengths of Teacher Dashboard is the ability for teachers to view students' work all in one screen. So it saves you from having multiple tabs open in multiple places. So right now, what I've done is I've just come into my dashboard for my Year 7 English class. I have my students all show up and I can see all the work that those students are working on, so long as those students have put that work into the English folder in their Drive account. Now, if you'd love to see a video on how Teacher Dashboard works, you can see our other videos on our YouTube channel. Just go to usingtechnologybetter.com and just do a search for Teacher Dashboard and on our blog, and all of those videos will come up. So a great feature is being able to see all student work. One of the other great features that Teacher Dashboard has is that you're enabled to see all your students' work in their Google Sites, in their Blogger. So all of the Google products are featured inside Teacher Dashboard, but they're not there in Classroom just yet. Another one of the great features of Teacher Dashboard is the ability to see your students' work regardless of which folder it's in. So I can see all my students' unshared work, their public folders and their external folders, all their documents, and can even get visibility into their trash if I wanted to as well. So by using this, I can see all students' work regardless of which folder it's in, and even if it sits outside of that Google Classroom environment. One of the other features that we have inside Teacher Dashboard is the Interact feature, where we can see what all of our students are doing if they're using Chrome as a browser. And we are able to interact with their screen. So we're able to send students messages. We're able to open up tabs on their screens for them. And in fact, we can even send messages to the whole class, and we can open up tabs for the whole class, which is another great feature. So there's a whole load of features in here. One of the features that you do have here is Smart Copy. And with Smart Copy, you can select multiple files. You can see that you can select up to 5 at the moment. Now, just like Google Classroom, one of the things that you can do is you can share documents with your students. I guess one of the weaknesses of Teacher Dashboard is that it takes a little bit of time for this to process. If you're going to share a document with a whole class, it can take several minutes for that to happen. But just like Classroom, you can select several documents at once and push them through. It doesn't just have to be Google documents, it can be any kind of document, just like Classroom can do as well. The good thing about this is, though, that when you're sharing, you can select which class to share it through to, or you can share it with just individual students or groups of students. So that's one great feature that teachers are loving. So if you're one of the schools that has the ability to use Google Classroom and you'd like to use Teacher Dashboard, there's a great way to be able to work in this. The two can work together nicely. If I was going to share out a document, one of the things I would do is I would share that document out to the class using Google Classroom. And then what I would ask the students to do would be to take that document and then put it into the particular folder that you need them to put it into for Teacher Dashboard, which would give them a viewability just here. Now, just be aware that when your students move that document into their Teacher Dashboard folder, they can still access it from Classroom and they can still view it and edit it. But as soon as that student turns that in, it will no longer be viewable here. So the teacher would then need to go back to Classroom to be able to mark that work, review it, and then hand it back to the students. So you can use both together quite well. So in my next video, I'm going to show you how this feature works and give you a demonstration of how we would share a document out using Google Classroom, view it as a student's work inside Teacher Dashboard, and then go back to Classroom to mark it and then send it back to the student. If you've got any questions, we'd love you to just type your question in the comment section underneath this video, and we can be able to continue the discussion there. If you'd like a free demonstration of Teacher Dashboard for your school, or maybe even a free account to trial, then just simply send an email to our help team. The email is just there on your screen, and one of our team will be able to contact you and then get you started to see how we can best serve you in that. So hopefully you're enjoying both Classroom and Teacher Dashboard together, and we'll see you in the next video.